Installing SysInternals tools. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. If you've followed me for any length of time, you'll know that I very often refer to SysInternals from Microsoft as a good source of tools. You may not recognize SysInternals, but you will recognize things like Process Explorer or the Auto Runs tools. Well, I just discovered that Microsoft has made that entire suite of tools available in the Microsoft Store, which is a very, very cool thing for a couple of different reasons. One is it makes installing them a snap, and it also keeps them up to date automatically. The apps you install from the Microsoft Store are updated automatically. So let's have a look at how these tools get installed, where they show up, how to use a couple of them anyway, and then also if you've got cleanup, as I did, you can find out where these tools were installed so that you know which ones you can safely delete from your own duplicate copy if you've already installed some of these. So here we are in Windows 10. We're going to go ahead and hit the Microsoft Store, and we'll just search for SysInternals. You're looking for the SysInternals suite. We'll click on Get. SysInternals includes a number of different tools. The suite installs all of them. So we'll go ahead and install that. There are several tools that, to be honest, you may never ever use, but because this is so much easier than tracking down the individual downloads and expanding the zip files and copying the files to places so that you can use them, basically these apps have been installed, which is fantastic. We're done. We can close the store. Where they've been installed is on your start menu. If we scroll down, you'll see that Auto Runs is already here. SysInternals Suite is here as recently added. And I believe if we scroll down to the S's here, there's SysInternals Suite. If we click on that, we'll get information about what these tools are, which we may or may not find useful, but more useful are the individual tools that are now on your start menu. Access Enum, Auto Login, Auto Runs is a tool that I've recommended before. Scrolling down here to my all-time favorite, we'll find Process Explorer right here. Process Monitor is another tool that comes in. I'm just going to file up Process Explorer so that you know what it is we're talking about. You can see that it's already running, and we'll go ahead and make it larger. This, as I've referred to in the past, is essentially Task Manager on steroids. There are a lot of different things you can do here with Process Explorer. There's a lot you can do with Task Manager, don't get me wrong, but for a lot of us, the extra detail, the extra tools, the extra visibility you can get using Process Explorer is desirable. And like I said, there's a bunch of other tools that are installed. I'll go ahead and run Auto Runs just because that's another tool that I've referenced in several places on Ask Leo. This is a tool that tells you absolutely everything that is run automatically when you fire up Windows or when you log in. As you can tell, it's a very, very long list when you're looking at everything. There's all sorts of different things here related to the various tools installed on this system. And this isn't even a particularly heavily used system. This is one of my example Windows 10 machines. But you can see that there's a lot of stuff here. But the good news, the reason that this is such an interesting thing and such an important thing, is that we now have these tools installed using the Microsoft Store. I'm going to go ahead and back to SysInternals in the store, and you can see that it is already installed on this device. You can install it on other devices if you want. So this is another machine associated with this particular account. I'm not going to do that now. I'll do that from the machine. And of course, you can pin the SysInternals suite to your start or your taskbar. As we've seen, SysInternals suite by itself is not particularly useful since it's only giving you the documentation page for the full SysInternals. It's the individual tools that you'll now find on your start menu that are useful. Now, there is one caveat that I'm going to throw out here. I have installed this on my Windows 11 machine. You're looking at Windows 10 right now. On Windows 11, the sysinternal suite gets installed as a submenu of your start menu. So rather than taking you to the documentation for sysinternals, if you see sysinternals on your Windows 11 start menu, you will see that it actually expands to list all the individual tools. But that's a minor difference. All the individual tools are there. All the individual tools are ready for you to use. I hope this was helpful. It got me pretty excited just because I use these tools a lot. If you're interested in updates, related links, comments, and more, visit askleo.com/137883. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.